CCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
Welcome to the Institute Presents. I'm Susan Rohn, the Executive Director. First of all, happy Valentine's Day, and thank you for joining us. And today we have two very special people with us. Speaking of Valentine's, Fran Parzanesy, who is president of the Berks Art Alliance, and Mary Button, who is committee chair of the exhibition, exhibitions. And we currently have a Berks Art Alliance exhibit that opened on Sunday. February 12th, and we're going to talk a little bit about that. But the Berks Art Alliance has been at the Institute for many, many years. In fact, we're trying to figure out how many.
Right, we don't really know.
And Fran, you seem to think that maybe it was in the 70s that they
at least in started. The 70s, mm-hmm. if not before that. Maybe the 60s. I'm not really sure. I joined in 1983, and it was at the Institute, so I really don't know what happened before that.
Wonder how old is it? Do you know?
I'm sorry, I don't know. I mean, I have a brochure at home, but I really don't know how old it is.
It's probably been around since the 50s.
Yes, at least in the 50s. I think it was started from one of the women that moved from New York, and I think she wanted a group in the area to work with because she had been involved then. And then it evolved. They changed the name. I can't recall the original name, but it was a
different name. Was it the Art League, the original name?
I'm not sure.
I'm trying to remember because when we were did the Coggins exhibit, we got into a lot of the Berks Art Alliance because he was so active. Yes. And he was at the Institute, you know, teaching as master classes. But it's interesting, and I think it may have been some art league or something. And you seem to think Mary Woolley probably started
I think Mary Woolley was instrumental in getting a group together and starting it to give art information to everyone and spread the artwork in the area. And then it evolved into larger quarters and more members, and then they changed the name.
And then you moved to the Institute, which is a long time. So why don't you talk a little bit about the Berks Art Alliance as far as the mission, or what are you doing in the community even currently, and how is membership growing?
Well, okay. Our mission statement really is to promote the arts in Berks County and promote artists and art appreciators. I don't have my brochure with me, but we're trying to grow our membership. It's a wonderful group of, like I said, artists and art appreciators, and we have five meetings a year. five meetings a year, all held at the Institute, the second Tuesdays of the months of September, November, January, March, and May.
That's a general meeting.
That's
a big
general meeting
that you have in the gallery.
We have that meeting in the gallery, and they're all really interesting meetings. We have artists who come, a different artist from different mediums, to present programs. Our programs are very interesting. We try to get somebody from a different field of art. Some presenters give lectures, slideshows. We try to get people to do a little demo of their work. And really, some of these demos have been so interesting. For example, we had a girl named Amy Stauffer who did a little demo last year on scratchboard art. One of our artists was there watching it, took meticulous notes, went home, did a beautiful scratchboard painting, entered into another show, and won an award. Deb Gurman, who had been our president years ago, watched a demo. She was there, of course, when we had a demo, this was years ago, on somebody who did encaustic painting. She went home, that started her doing encaustic painting.
Yeah, we have one of her paintings to show people.
Yes, we do.
In fact, I think that were there some scratchboard paintings in the current exhibit
I don't believe it.
None?
I did not see any. No.
There was in the one of the exhibits at the Goggle Work. Works, and she won one of the prizes. I think she won third prize.
Right.
In the show.
Right. That was our juried show.
That's your juried show.
It was extraordinary, yes.
That's usually in the fall?
That's in the fall, and our next one will be coming up in the fall. So we have five meetings a year. We do run, like I said, like you alluded to, this wonderful juried show, mm-hmm. which is open to any artist from really around the country.
Right.
It's digital entry. We have the prospectuses out. If anybody would like to enter the show, you can just go log on to berksartalliance.org, I think is our mm-hmm. website,
so,
and download the prospectus. But we're going to have them out in all different kinds of places around Berks County. And then, in addition to the juried show, we have, this year we're having three membership shows.
Mm-hmm. Well, you have one at the Institute now, which is open to anybody.
Right.
You don't.
No, it's open just to our members.
Yes, but I meant you don't jury it. It's
no,
just
that's
anybody
right. it's
can
not
submit
jury.
Anything.
Right, that's what a membership show
okay,
is.
Yes.
A membership show is open to members. They're not juried. Juried means you enter and you're judged and you're either accepted or not.
Which gets tough sometimes.
Yes. We're trying, of course, I think, like all organizations are today, trying to attract younger members. We haven't finalized. We have some ideas we're kicking around on how to get younger members involved. We have bus trips at least two a year. One in, usually in the spring to New York to the American Watercolor Society show. One in September to the Pastel show. Excuse me. And we still have some openings for the show, for the trip this spring. It will be Saturday, April 15th.
April 15th, okay.
Yes.
Last year it was the day before, the day after Dancing with the Running Stars. I remember. There's no way. As much as I wanted to go, that there's no way. But the 15th is the day before Easter.
It's the day before Easter. So there's still a lot, still art trip seats left on the bus trips. Oh, the wonderful thing, the other wonderful thing we do, thanks to our connection with you at the Weimassy Institute, is we rent a classroom, as you know, upstairs, mm-hmm. which is available to us every Thursday of the whole year. Mm-hmm. And in the mornings from 9:30 to 12:30, we organize a portrait painting class. We call it a workshop, but there's really no instruction involved. Yeah. People come, they bring any kind of art material they want. Some people bring pencils, charcoal, watercolor, oil, acrylic, it doesn't matter. And for 3 hours, they paint the model. In the afternoon, we have still at the Institute from 1 until 3. We have, it's a combination of things.
Well,
sometimes it's still life.
Still life.
Sometimes it's mixed mm-hmm. media. If somebody went to a class and they learned something new, they share it with everybody. Mm-hmm. And then in the evening, twice a month now, we have life drawing, mm-hmm. which is a nude model.
Which one is, I mean, if you're trying to attract younger people and looking at the way things have changed with everybody working, when the Art Alliance was started, a lot of women did not work at that point.
That's
but
true.
But now, everybody's working.
True.
So, which is the evening session the best attended?
Oh, no.
No?
No, the evening session is now down to only twice a month.
Because of it.
Because attendance is dropping off. We don't know why. Pendulums swing back and forth.
That's
years
true.
Ago, the morning workshop was very poorly attended, was hardly making it. Now they are overfilled.
That could have something to do with the aging of a population.
Well, yes,
too.
People are retired mm-hmm. now, so they can
exactly.
come in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Members are getting older. They don't really like to go out at night so much anymore. And then in the summertime, we have plein air mm-hmm. where we get together and go out to. We're so lucky to live here in Berks County. We have so many beautiful places to paint.
You really do. You have beautiful places to paint. And Berks County is full of the arts, which is wonderful.
Yes, it is.
You know, you've got so much. You've got the museum. You've got the Goggle Works. You've got the Institute, which is the educational mm-hmm. kernel of the arts. I mean, we are a community-based organization that educates and
Goggle Works,
the arts.
Right? Mm-hmm.
I did.
Because Goggle Works is a place where we also hold several workshops a year where we bring in nationally known artists to teach.
Yes.
And we have four of those coming up.
Good. When are they coming?
Okay. Let's see. Excuse me. Mm-hmm. We're having like Amy Stauffer, who I said is does the scratch board. Mm-hmm. She's coming very soon, February 24th and 25th. These are all weekend workshops. We have a wonderful person in charge of coordinating our workshops named Donna Unger, and she did an awesome job of organizing 4 workshops. Then, actually, Donna has become pretty much of an expert in her own right, mm-hmm. using alcohol inks, along with another one of our members, Laurel Arbogast, and they're going to do a workshop on alcohol inks on March 25th and 26th. And then the following month, April 29th and the 30th, is experimental mixed media with Julie Jans-Rupp, and she teaches right now in York. Mm-hmm. And then on May 20th and 21st, we're having a workshop with a nationally known watercolor artist named David Lee. Now, you do not have to really be a member of the Art Alliance to take these workshops.
Now, this is all being held at the Goggle Works.
At the Goggle Works.
And you're on the program committee there, aren't you?
Yes.
Yes, I thought you were. I thought you had talked to me about that one time.
Yes, I am.
Yes, I thought so.
And I also teach there, too.
That's good.
I teach watercolor there, too.
Well, didn't you have a studio there?
Excuse me. Yes, I do have a studio
You
there.
Still have it? Okay, mm-hmm. I wasn't mm-hmm. sure. I get in and out, and it changes so much.
I know.
But I'm never sure who's actually still there.
Yes, I know. There's a lot
well,
of turnover.
Things change.
Well, everything
that's right.
changes.
That's not bad either.
I should say they have a lot of turnover. They do not have a lot of turnover.
I think it's more stable now.
It's more stable. Mm-hmm. It's a wonderful place to be. Mm-hmm. But we're certainly grateful to the Institute mm-hmm. for all that you do for us. And you are our home. And we love it. We love being there.
Well, I know. We love having you. We really do. It adds another dimension.
It's
we have
wonderful.
From the 2-year-olds to 85 or 90-year-olds. It's kind of nice. Because you see it from all points of view.
Right.
It's great. It adds a great dimension to the Institute.
Thank you.
Back to the show that is current. Mary is the chairman of that committee, the exhibition committee. And maybe we want to talk a little bit about the show. We do have some pictures, some reproductions. And not reproductions, they're digital pictures of what's hanging in there, and I think you'd find it quite interesting. This is by Mary Lou Kreitz. Savannah.
Yes. And this is pastel, and mm-hmm. she actually won a prize for, it's in memory of Paul Delp, who was a member and very important in the morning workshop on Thursday. So they have presented a prize to one of the paintings that depicting a person or living creature. So they wanted to have a tribute to Paul. So Mary Lou won that. This is her granddaughter, Savannah.
Yes, it is. It's beautiful. Mm-hmm. It really is. Now let's see. That got an, yes, that one was, oh, and here's the first prize, right?
This is Russ Slocum. This is an oil. He said he painted it in Maine near Acadia National Park. And he said, luckily, he was painting there, and all of a sudden the man went in and pulled out this boat, which he was familiar with, I'm not, but he was thrilled, and it's a beautiful painting. He won first prize, and these exhibits are for the members. Each member is entitled to put one painting in, and we actually have 83 submissions and one sculpting, 83 paintings and one sculpture in this one. This is one of the largest that we've had for a while.
I didn't know how many they were allowed to put in.
One each.
Just one.
Yeah,
is
just
that
one painting.
Standard every year?
Yes.
Okay.
And it's our, the Yoakum, we have the membership show there. We have a membership show at Highlands. And this year we're having a special membership show at the Miller Center.
When
are you
having
performing
that?
Arts. That, the reopening reception on that is March 19th, 1 to 3 p.m. And it will be there for a month. But it will be on the second floor. And mm-hmm. And they're treating us to this special event. So
that's
great.
Wonderful. They're good partners.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
in the community,
they are.
The Miller Center. They're mm-hmm. wonderful partners with us. We're part of their series.
The members vote for this.
Yes,
show,
and at this particular
vote.
Show, yes, at Yoakum, we vote, the peers vote for the winners. We have a first, second, and third prize, and this year, 4 honorable mentions. And then we had the special award for Paul Delp, which was the first time this year. The other shows are just, they're an exhibition of what you're doing and what we like to show. Everyone has one choice, mm-hmm. one painting to put in, or piece of art.
Okay, well, let's see if we can get to the next one. Okay, This is Rain. This didn't get any awards, but it just intrigued a number of us at the Institute. So we did a digital of it. And
thought, oh, it's nice. Yes.
It's a watercolor by Cheryl
Elmo. Cheryl Elmo, yes. She has a really specific manner of painting, and it's quite unusual, but she's won many awards in a lot of shows that she's been, and she does a special, unique watercolor technique. And that's beautiful work. She had a show in one of the big galleries in town.
Did
also,
she?
But it's her work is beautiful.
It is. It's lovely work. It really
and
everything
it's unusual.
There.
Unusual.
This is
yes.
an extremely strong show this year.
It's spectacular. It really
yes,
is. We got a lot
really
of nice
is.
Reviews, and it's hung so beautifully. We have wonderful volunteers that help for intake and hanging and
it's
pickup, and they did a great job with hanging. So.
Despite the snow, which
yes,
slowed it down
yes,
a little.
Yes, the weather, and
worked
we had
well.
A, we had to postpone one day. Yes, but it was. Beautifully hung, and this is one of the nicest paintings. So, a lot of it is nice. It's beautiful.
There's so many there. It's hard to pick.
Right.
So let's go to the next one. And this, Barbara Post.
Yes, Barbara won one of the honorable mention. I believe.
Yes, she yes, did. House on the Hill.
A collage.
House on Hill.
A collage or mixed medium. She presents.
Mm-hmm. That's Barbara. Does some very unique things.
Yes, and she's really a longtime does. Member and a great volunteer. She's been in the group a long time. She probably would know a lot of the history more
she
so
probably
than
does.
I would. Yeah,
great supporter of the arts.
Yes, she is.
She is anywhere. She really is. She's a lovely person. Okay, and we're on to the art quilt, which is Martha Ressler.
Martha Ressler does beautiful techniques in her embroidery. And she's connected with the Art Plus Gallery in West Reading, mm-hmm. and shows her work, wins a lot of prizes. She and her husband have a studio, I think, in Hamburg. And,
oh, do they?
And
okay.
Yes.
I didn't realize that.
Yes. Well, he does photography, and she does the quilting.
I've heard about their work,
beautiful.
Though.
Yes, their work
I
is
have,
beautiful. And I think she had a show at the YR Club, too, with her quilting.
Martha, did
yes.
she?
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember, but she may have.
Yes.
Absolutely. In fact, this segues into our next exhibit. Which
oh,
is
good.
The Art of Quilt.
Oh, there you go, yeah.
At Quilt Art, and it's by Janet Henshaw.
Oh.
Janet and her husband own Landis Store.
Oh, wow,
and she'll
okay.
probably be on with us next
okay.
month, but
oh,
it's an
great.
Interesting story,
how
how she got into it and how she grew up at Landis Store.
Oh, my gosh.
So it's really interesting, but this is, she doesn't quite do this, but she does some very interesting things.
Sure.
In fact, there's a quilt that I know she's made that is completely of ties.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's very, she's wonderful.
Well, quilting
okay,
is
okay, we
amazing.
Better move on here to the second prize
oh.
by Fran Parzanesy.
Yes.
That was kind of an amazing experience for me because as the president, Mary and I counted the ballots. And then I was really shocked and extremely honored to, well, actually, I tied for second prize.
Yeah, you tied.
But I had to present the award to myself.
That's not bad. I saw it. You did an excellent
Thank
job.
You. Thank
you. Were
you.
Very humble.
Thank you.
You really were. That's a, it's a wonderful painting.
It's
really,
a watercolor.
It's very spring.
Yeah.
Isn't it called spring?
It's called Moths of Spring.
Moths of Spring.
Actually, I started that as a demo this past spring in one of my classes I teach at Goggle Works. And the lesson was to save a path of white through the painting. Hmm. Can't really see it too much on this reproduction.
Yeah.
But then, of course, right. I took it home and worked a little bit more. And then it was also to introduce a little bit of mixed media. You can't see it too well, but there are little pieces of Chinese rice paper pasted on there to give it a three-dimensional look. So it's a combination of mostly organic shapes with a little bit of three-dimensional look.
Okay.
Beautiful.
Second prize. Pretty good, Fran.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
This one is a mixed media also. And it is, let me see.
Maryland Bayshore.
You know who it is?
Maryland Bayshore. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Bayshore.
Can I talk a little bit about it, Mary?
And this is sort of three-dimensional in a way. She has buttons attached to the painting. It's abstract design, but it's very colorful and very interesting. So she got honorable mention, and it was really different.
It is different.
Mm-hmm.
It's very nice.
It's very different and unique.
Yes. As Fran said earlier, she thinks in every category there was some kind of an award, which is
yes,
good.
Yes, it was
well.
Amazing. It mm-hmm. wasn't planned. It was just
no. It just happened.
It happened that
choose.
Way.
Yeah, it's amazing.
And this was just one along the river. by Gail Poor. It's an acrylic.
Oh, yes.
It's just, the colors just appeal
to. Yeah, she is very colorful with her paintings, and her designs are mostly abstract, but she's a wonderful artist, and her work is very popular in shows.
And this got an award, too.
Yes.
By Amy Shade.
It's Amy Shade. I think she's one of the honorable mention, and she works in abstract and realism combined, and she has such a unique of blending the subjects together. She works in acrylic and I think mixed media sometime. Mm-hmm.
But I think that's what that is, too.
Is it mixed?
I think.
But she's very unusual with her realism and people in it, but yet always something abstract with it and incorporates them. And with her drawing, she does beautiful work.
I think she called it breviary. Okay, let's go on to the next one. And that one is second prize, too.
Right.
You want to talk about it? Cowfish on Parade.
Ed Hakem.
Ed Hakem. Bob Hakem.
Bob Hakem, yeah. We got a lot of comments on that. It's the only piece of sculpture in the show, but it's beautifully done and very interesting. I don't know, I couldn't imagine finding all those objects and putting them together in such a beautiful form, but it was absolutely beautiful, and we got a lot of comments on it.
Somebody asked if it was actually a fish.
I think that's what it's depicting. Oh, you mean an actual fish? Mm-hmm. I doubt it.
I didn't think so.
Does he have the materials in there? It was all metallic.
Well, I wasn't going to touch it. I'm deathly allergic to them. Seriously, I wasn't getting near that fish. That would have been a true test.
Yes. I doubt that it is. I don't recall that he said anything, but it was very, very complimentary remarks on it. It was very popular, and it was interesting.
I remember a few years ago, we had a teacher that came in with the kids, and she brought all kinds of things in for them, and she brought in a fish that they were dipping in paint, and she was a fabulous teacher.
Oh, like stamping.
Uh-huh, she was fabulous, but they had to scrub the room. So if I go in there and touch them, they're that fish.
Oh, well, no.
It was a real interesting experience. And then we go on to Pears by Peter Schnorr.
Well, Peter Schnorr is quite an accomplished artist in the area, and it's absolutely beautiful. It's just a beautiful painting. You could even smell the varnish of it when he brought it in, and I love that. I work in oils, and I love that smell.
It's beautiful.
But it's very beautifully done. He's quite an accomplished artist and for many, many years in Berks County. I think people know him.
Yes.
And he's come to Art Alliance for a lecture in one of our programs.
And then we have Deb Gurman's Encaustic with Pastel, which is a faded life.
Oh, that is exceptional. Mm-hmm. She said that down at the shore, the water brushed the bird, a dead bird, mm-hmm. onto her feet, up to her feet, and she just felt compelled to paint it. But it's, I think it's pastel underneath and then the encaustic on it. And
it
has won in other shows, has won several prizes for this particular painting. It's absolutely beautiful.
Didn't she have something in the catalog for the American Watercolor Society a few years ago, too?
I believe she did.
No, I think it was a pastel show.
Maybe it was pastel. Mm-hmm. I thought it was watercolor.
Well, she's represented.
Pastel. She works in pastel.
Mm-hmm. She just got into the Corning Gallery in New York.
She was telling me.
She's quite
accomplished.
Yes, and she was past president of our organization for several years.
Number of years.
She and her husband.
She kept getting it back.
Yes.
And that was an honorable mention.
Yes.
And that's the same one. And it looks to me like that's it. I think we've gone through all of them. Amazing.
Well, it's a beautiful show.
It is, and I invite everyone to please come see it.
The show closes March 13th, so.
Okay, so it will be, and then the next one opens the 17th with the quilts. So that about does it for February for us, and thank you for joining us. Just a few things to mention before we close. Our next show opens March 17th. St. Patrick's Day, actually, at 5 o'clock, and that's the quilt show. We also have The Fisherman and His Wife at the Miller Center opening on March 31st, and that is quite a wonderful show. It's a family show. It's part of the Miller Center Family Series, which we are a part of every year. And I think the whole family will enjoy it. Chris Heslop has done the music for it. I believe Joel Gorey is directing it. So it should be a fabulous show. Good family show. A lot coming up with Berks Jazz Fest. Please check our website. And don't forget, Dancing with the Reading Stars is April 21st. We have quite a lineup this year. We'll talk about that next month. And don't forget, camp starts. Registration for certain camps start. Camp starts the end of February. You can register. If you register by March 15th, you can get the prices from 2016. After the 15th, they go up a little bit. Just the cost of doing business right now. And also, Broadway Junior is open, and it's a wonderful, you can register for that right now. That is wonderful this year. It's Dr. Doolittle. So we have people signing up right and left already. So thank you for joining us, and thank you, ladies, for joining us. It's been wonderful. Happy Valentine's Day, and we look forward to seeing you next month.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.